to ensure the quality of your project, the work you have done. At the same time, quality of guidance inputs given by the respected guide. Like, this incident said, nervous होने की जरूरत नहीं है. Another request I wish to make, that at least one of the projectee or guide or some other student should note the input, suggestion, comments given by the today's expert and try to implement all those things well before your external viva of project. ठीक है, अभी अपने को लग रहा है कि अपना project का output आ गया, अपना सब काम हो गया, पर आपको भी खुद ही समझ में आएगा जब उसके ऊपर क्वेश्चनिंग होगी, तब आपको पता चलेगा कि अपन कहाँ पे हैं. तो जो भी आपको कमेंट सजेशन मिलेंगे, प्लीज ट्राई टू इनकॉर्पोरेट ऑल दो सजेशंस, कमेंट्स, इनपुट्स इन योर प्रोजेक्ट वेल बिफोर योर एक्सटर्नल वाइवा. एट द सेम टाइम आई रिक्वेस्ट ईच एंड एवरी गाइड, इन केस ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ देयर रिस्पेक्टेड ग्रुप आर नॉट एबल टू आंसर एनी ऑफ द क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड बाय द एक्सपर्ट, at least guys should support them. Okay? So I wish you all the best for your this QI initiative. And on behalf of RGI and on my personal behalf, I welcome my one of my close friends, Dr. Asutkar, Vice Principal PIET, having around 28 or 30 years of experience in this, and one of the renowned experts in our electronics and ETC branch. So once again, wish you all the best. Thank you.
Next, please. Next. Introduction. Next slide. Today's world is flooded with the technologies. One of the technology we use is IoT, and many of you may have seen an advertisement where a person leaves his home and forget to switch off his devices at home, like maybe a geyser or AC. Having fire from his home, he is still able to switch off his devices with the help of IoT. The three technologies which are really fascinating today are IoT and AI and machine learning. So we thought, what if we implement the IoT on existing system, that is a robotic arm controlled by Bluetooth technology, and Bluetooth technology has a confined communication due to its limited range. So we thought if we come up with the IoT, so that the system will work on far distance and can be controlled from any corner of the world. Next.
We are finding a earlier module that is Arduino based Bluetooth control robotic arm. And it is published in 2016. And we are finding a established wireless connectivity Bluetooth and the robotic arm after publishing in IJEEE journal. After that, our next module will be come, that is a designing of controlling robotic arm. This is also published in 2016. And it will control by a hand gesture using Bluetooth. Now we are working next designing of control robotic arm to be wireless control from any location. We have giving a real-time visual access from our output.
Here we have used hand gesture control robotic arm by using IoT. Therefore, we come up with the ideas of IoT-based hand gesture control robotic arm. It will control by any location of your world, and it will very helpful for real time visual access.
Next. Next slide.
So basically talking about the proposed methodology of our system. So first part is, as we can see, accelerometer, Arduino, remote control. This is basically a transmitter section, which will manipulate the hand gestures control movements of our finger and implement and convert it into electrical signal, and thus will be providing to the Arduino. And along with that, we are giving a second input, remote control, which we have designed using C# language in HTML coding. It is a virtual remote which will be used to control that two moments, means four moments of that wheel over which the jaw is mounted. So basically, this was all about transmitter section. Now talking about the server. Server is basically, we have used a free SP hosting .NET server to which we will transmit the whole data using ESP module, which is electronic stability provider. It uses TCP/IP protocol for communication. It has four pins, 3.3 volt supply, ground pin, transmitter pin, and receiver pin. So now talking about the receiver section of our project is that whole module, which you can see in your front. So basically the receiver section also comprises of ESP Wi-Fi module 8266, Arduino second, and a robotic arm, as we can see here. So basically the receiver section, as per our hand gestures, we will get the actual moment of our jaw, and it can be controlled from any global location. Next slide. This is how our whole system, transmitter, receiver, and server works. So as we can see, as soon as we start both the transmitter and receiver section, the camera will be first on. So now we need to check whether our object which is to be picked is far away from the robot. So we will give a RC high input. If RC input will be high, then it will act in a DC motor, as we can see in the wheels. So the wheel will move forward, backward, leftward, rightward as per our instruction. And second case arises, if the object is nearer to our motorcycle, then yes sir. Yes sir, it is completed, but there are some delays. Yes sir, we have. Okay sir, sorry to say. So, and second condition arises, if the object to be picked is nearer to our robot, so no need to give any instruction, we will directly give a hand gesture instruction, so the actual movement of the arm will, as per our, as you can see in that arm, we have used accelerometer GY61. It is a 3-axis accelerometer giving four types of output at a time. So basically there we have, as in the program, we have set some ranges of the accelerometer, like 100 to 200, 200 to 300, 300 to 400, and 400 to 500. For every range, we have given one instruction. For movement of jaw in upward direction, he will need to give the upward direction. The accelerometer finger will be up, down, left, right. That's how the whole system works.
Implementation. At first we tested the receiver side, and in the receiver side is the robotic arm mounted on a car using Bluetooth for implementation of the movement of system at a particular time or a distance if a certain input is given, and for analysis. To achieve the concept of IoT, we need a server. So we are using FreeASPhost.net. It is a free server to fetch the data from the transmitter using the Wi-Fi module, and the data will be received by the robotic arm in the server on the Wi-Fi module to perform the operation. We have using C# to generate the buttons on web page to control the motion of car. We uploaded program in Arduino to manipulate input from the gesture and fetch the data to the server. Similarly, we also uploaded program in Arduino at the receiver side, so as to act according to the received data. We are also giving the IP camera to get the real-time visual access. This is the innovative work, and we are using the concept of IoT, and we modified the existing system, that is the Bluetooth control robotic arm, and we are using concept of IoT so as to change the application. With the help of IoT, we can connect or communicate to physical devices anywhere in the world. But as the far existing system concerned, communication is confined to a certain limit. We use IP camera to get the real-time visual access. का है.
So here is what a circuit diagram for a receiver side. Here you can see one Arduino and two L298 ICs. Basically, Arduino has a three port BCD. B and D are for digital pins, and talking about C is a analog pin. There are 14 digital pins, from which 6 are used for PWM pins, that is pulse width modulation for controlling of the speed of a motor. The L298 IC can drive two motors and can perform a four operation by giving instruction clockwise or anti-clockwise to one rotation, and similarly for the second. So here is what a 12 volt supply we have given. Basically, it needs 12 volt, 5 volt, and ground. 12 volt for driving the motor, and 5 volt for IC. And secondly, here is a ESP8266 module to fetching the data into the server. Next. Here is a circuit diagram for hand gesture. In transmitter side, we used an Arduino and ESP and accelerometer. Accelerometer has already my friend said three axes of by which we can give six inputs. And here is what a ESP8266 is to get a data from a server, and a 9 volt battery supply or 5 volt battery is needed for running of this module. And here is a microcontroller 8 mega 326. Next.
So these are the results of our project hand gesture control robotic arm. The first one is car on which arm is mounted is able to move from one place to the another place. Suppose this is a Land Rover vehicle. If we are giving the input to this robotic vehicle via hand virtual remote in certain inputs, such as the inputs are forward direction, reverse direction, left forward, and right forward. If particular input is given, then according to that robot is act according to. The second one is the robotic arm is able to pick and drop objects. We are placing the arm over there, over the robotic vehicle. We are giving the inputs to this robotic arm via hand gesture. Then there are lots of products we need to be shifted in warehouse, as well as there are lots of stuffs we need to be shifted in storeroom. By using this robotic vehicle or robotic arm, we can shift this very easily. The third one is the controlling of whole system is based on the concept of IoT. It is an IoT-based concept. The fourth one is the system provides real-time visual access. If the operator is far away from the robot, then operator need to see what is actually happening with the robot. Then that's why we are placing the IP camera over there. The system can be used in very far hazardous areas, provided that there must be internet availability. In coal mines, we can use this robot for handling the coal, as well as taking out the coal from coal mines very easily. We can use this robot in coal mines, nuclear power plants. The nuclear power plants, as we all know, that this is a very where the percentage of causing injuries for humans is very high. By using this robot in nuclear power plants, we can reduce this. Injuries for humans, we can reduce this by using this robot. But we need to be ensure that in both cases, in coal mines as well as nuclear power plants, there must be an internet availability. Next slide. So these are the conclusions and future scope of our project hand gesture control robotic arm. The first one is the further the system can be made to use by normal people as well as by special able people, whole controlling can be done by the gesture only. We can design this robot in such a manner where normal people can use this, but special people can also use this. Suppose I am giving the example, any army officer who lost their legs in a war situation, but he can't individual perform their work at in their home. They show their patrioticness towards the country. If the army officer use this robot vehicle, he can perform so many works at their home. This is a small tribute towards them. The second one is presence of operator at particular workplace is not mandatory. He can she operate the system from his her place. At any particular place we can operate this vehicle, the operator no need to present at there. He or she can operate any far from anywhere in the world. The third one is in future, if the speed of internet increases, then the system will be more reliable to use. If these multiple operations, the system can be performed smoothly. If we are giving the good speed of internet to this robotic vehicle, it performs very smoothly any task on more reliable functions. Next slide. These are the references we are taking the help from it. Next. These are the certificates we are participating in the Maulana Azad National Institute of Technology placed in Bhopal. These are paper presentations. Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, approximately 5,800.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
No, sir. No, sir. That IP camera cost about 1,100, but it was not available. So
we are placing a. No. Next slide.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
All components.
Most important is visible. How many hours
did
the
study
take?
What?
Sir,
actually,
we have
tested it
3 times
earlier.
How many hours? Times.
Times.
Seconds. Minutes.
Sir, actually, sometimes it works very fast if the internet connectivity is fast and if the server is working properly, but sometimes due to server management problems. ASP, PSP hosting.net, we have. Yes, sir.
Server time.
Internet.
Cloud.
We have used
cloud. The cloud one you are using is communication, how the communication established with the cloud.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Sir, hum virtual remote use kar rahe
hain. Use the word cloud.
Yes.
So how is communication established to the cloud?
Sir, actually, ESP is sending all the data to the cloud and the same data is fetched.
Yes.
So we have coded.
Via virtual remote.
Means are you asking about sending and receiving data?
Yeah. Communication at the cloud is established.
Okay, sir. Actually, sir, firstly, we have coded the code of Wi-Fi using RD.
Not ask you about the identity of coding.
Yes, sir.
How communication is established between the server and your device?
Wirelessly.
Wirelessly.
Yes, sir.
Firstly, it goes from the server. Firstly, it goes from
the
server.
Virtual remote
sample. That Wi-Fi only.
Wi-Fi.
Yes, sir.
Where is Wi-Fi is
possible? Sir, actually,
connected to everything?
No, sir. We need to turn off our mobile data, and it will be connected.
Turn off.
The two Wi-Fis are connected to.
I'm still not clear about how this communication is done. But you mentioned it was cloud server. Okay. Agree with the communication that is there.
Yes.
वर्चुअल रिमोट से हम लोग पहले वर्चुअल रिमोट से एक्ट करेंगे ना वर्चुअल रिमोट बोल देना वर्चुअल रिमोट वो वाय वर्चुअल रिमोट वर सेंडिंग द डेटा टू द सर्वर वाय वर्चुअल रिमोट
सर एक्चुअली वी आर गिविंग गेस्चर इनपुट फर्स्टली ओके दैट गेस्चर इनपुट
आप बोल रहे हैं सर्वर
yes.
इसका सर्वर का और इसका कम्युनिकेशन कैसा होगा डाटा एक्सचेंज कैसा होगा
सर वर्चुअल रिमोट से वर्चुअल रिमोट से ओपन करेंगे।
Sir, so basically the internet is all behind the scene. So basically the
simple job, wo jo server manager
hai. Yes sir.
My communication test. Just ask a very simple question. Just tell me how the communication stack is between your server and server. Wo jo aapne block kiya
hai. Yes sir.
Aur ye robotic arm. Aur aapka ye kya hai?
Ye robotic arm hai, wo hand gesture hai.
To uska communication test.
So this DSP wifi module to server, give it instruction to server, and then second wifi module.
Signal server कैसे आ रहा है और server से आपका arm या vector कैसे कर
रहा है? Okay sir. Sir can you show can we show you a demo? So how it is working?
Demo चलेगा.
No sir, actually we are talking about server, so we will show you on serial monitor.
Okay, you start with the demo.
Demo start. Mic sir. कोई ऑब्जेक्ट रखना पड़ेगा ना, पेन ले लेना, ये पेन सेलेक्ट दे, उसको सेलेक्ट जाके दे। जरूरत पड़ेंगे तो लेना ये ऑब्जेक्ट।
पोस्टर्स A3 साइज के
जल्दी जल्दी कर।
वो सब सही है, मतलब कम्युनिकेशन कैसा हो रहा है वो।
यस सर, फ्रॉम माय मोबाइल फोन टू कंट्रोल ऑफ द मूवमेंट ऑफ कार आई विल गिव फॉरवर्ड एंड फॉर द मोशन ऑफ जॉ ही विल गिव इंस्ट्रक्शन फ्रॉम हियर। सो बोथ द वाईफाई विल बी So both the ESP is connected to my phone.
तेरा हॉटस्पॉट तो देख फिर। तेरा हॉटस्पॉट दिया क्या?
Basically, our guide is Professor Vipin Bhure sir, and we are a team of 5 members. My name is Varun Salve, is Ashutosh Bhute, Akansha Pathe, Imran Ansari, and the last is Anup Bhute. Anup Bandre. Next slide, please. So, talking about smart PDS system, I would like to explain you about what exactly PDS is all about. PDS is nothing but the public distribution system, which is the rationing system of India. It was introduced in the year 1992, and it is organized and it is authorized and handled by the FCI, that is the Food Corporation of India. But all this while, there are happening many malpractices between this. This is the main concept for the BPL people, that is the below poverty line people. Now what we need to do is, having seen a lot of malpractices happening in the system, we have come up, researched about it, and we have seen the problems. We have seen the problems and we have came up with the solution for the same. So in the next slides, probably you'll see the what are the problems which we have recognized in the system and accordingly what solutions we have made for that. So we'll begin with the next slide. Move into the next slide. Next slide is, sorry. Yeah, so from the starting, like do I need, okay. Okay, I am, yeah, oh, sorry, yeah. All right, so, sir, the next slide is the literature survey slide. So this is what we have researched up until now.
So, my name is Ashutosh Bhute. I'm here to explain the literature survey. The paper title for first author is The Proposed Architecture for Automatic Public Distribution System by Chaitali Chandankede. It was published in International Conference of Computing, Communication and Automation. We found out that FPS dealers cannot maintain fake ration cards by this automatic public distribution system. Second is automatic ration material distribution based on GSM and RFID technology by R. Ramani and Fahim Akhtar. It was published in International Journal of Intelligent System and Applications, presented in New Delhi 2016. They found out that if not buy the materials at the end of the month, they will sell to other without any intimation or government or the customers. Third is real-time automation ration material distribution system by Pranjal Pedwal and Ms. Shubhangi Borkar. It was presented, it was published in International Journal of Science, Technology and Engineering in February 2016. We found out that the conventional ration material distribution system has drawbacks like weight of the material may be inaccurate due to the human mistake, low processing speed and long waiting time at the ration shops. Fourth one is smart card based public distribution system by Sanae Kadar and Dr. R.R. Dubey. It was published in International Journal of Advanced Research in Computer and Communication Engineering, May 2016. They used smart PDS can avoid corruption in rationing system to a large extent by providing transparency at each level. We will tell about everything in the coming slides. After that, fifth is home automation using Arduino by Manish Prasad and Pranav Kumar. It was published in International Journal of Engineering and Research and Technology, March 2017. This Arduino we have used, so I have given the some paper about Arduino Uno. So next slide.
Now let's talk about problems. Now what happens? The people belonging to the below poverty line have faced many problems. The problems are nothing but corruption like barbing, declaration of stock unavailability by the ration shopkeepers, the role of the middleman, and the timing problems. The dealer sells the poor quality grains at the ration shops. This is the problems they, we are faced in previously. Next slide.
My name is Imran Ansari. I want to explain proposed methodology. In my project, there are two types of methodology, first hardware and second software. Hardware refers to the physical components that's compromise all the necessary components to require the operate the machines. Software components, software commonly known as programs, apps, etc. By the help of software components, we are try to operate hardware components in our project. Next slide, please.
So implementation, the PDS project is designed in its simplest form, and we will be providing basic food commodities and also non-basic food commodities like kerosene and edible oil. This idea is made possibly practically by using supply of oil and kerosene. We have given the suggestion by Hardas sir that we need to introduce an OTP system for bank verification. We are introduced in this system the OTP. Thank you. Next slide.
Now let's see. This is a block diagram of our project. At Mega 328 is a heart of our project. At Mega 328 is 8-bit microcontroller to control all the components. Now let's see RFID tag and RFID reader. RFID tag detect the all the detect electromagnetic objects and send the information to RFID reader. RFID reader connect with at Mega 328 with serial interface. Motor driver circuit and motor MG966R. This is basically for the grains to open up and close the valve of this project's solenoid valve and solenoid valve control. It is only for liquids to control flow of liquids in the solenoid valve. Load cell is a measuring device to measure the weight of grain. Its capacity is 10 kg. GSM SIM 900A only the purpose of sending message customer as well as retailer. We are using here keyboard and laptop in the place of LCD display in the place of laptop.
This is a flowchart and phenomena of our project. We starting. My name is Anup Bandre. We starting from. This is a RF card. We store all information here, and when we scan this card to the RFID reader, we get all data in your screen. Your first step is to enter your personal pin, that is your card pin. You have to enter there. When you enter this pin, if your pin is successful, then you going to next step. Otherwise, it show invalid user and password, and you came back to your home screen. After getting your successful login, your ration card will be authenticated, and you get all information in this monitor or screen. Then our next step is to select quantity of food and grains. After selecting, there will be one screen will display, that is bank payment method. We directly link our account to the bank, and at that time your OTP will generate. And OTP are coming to the register mobile number. When you enter your OTP to the display, your process will complete and you dispatch your grain from the container. This is our last step, and your account is directly logged out. Next. This is a block diagram of our circuit diagram. In this diagram, we connect all the devices with the Arduino. This is a Arduino Atmega 328. Here we connect all the devices just like Servo motor is used to open or close the knob of container. This is a servo motor we use. Then we use solenoid valve for the liquid. This is a solenoid valve for the liquid we use. Then we use RFID reader. RFID reader, as I said, RFID reader is used to scan all the RFID cards. We directly connect it to the Arduino. Solenoid valve we connected with transistor for delay. And next is GSM module. GSM module we use to get OTP message, and after delivery, we get another message that confirm your delivery. Next is our load cell. Load cell we put here, and we use this load cell for weight measuring of grains and foods. This is all are connected with the Arduino through this data lines, bus lines. Next slide.
Yes, sir.
Number of quantity, whatever we want. After that, yes, we need to enter the pin. So basically what happened was there was a lot of disagreement between us and the shopkeepers. They were like, we don't need such machines. Already the government had proposed the Aadhaar card machine, which would be like the
between. You do not need this.
They are the ones who are like opposing it.
Nobody will oppose.
Unless and until the government supports us, so that's not an issue.
But you think that machine of the Indian
vendor machine?
Yes.
Yes, sir. It's right downstairs.
Same kind of person only in existence. We are talking about Tamil Nadu.
Right, sir. So, but they do.
But that's not practically implementation because the rain and everything requires a large space for.
Exactly. Right. This.
That's what I'm thinking about. Because I am thinking about practical implementation. Not only about the prototype. Is good. You get a mass, everything. But if your prototype or a project is not in position to convert it into product, certainly it's useless for me.
So this would be
sanctioned. This is a simple question. Can we implement this
in
a
product?
As a product,
yes.
In the shop?
Yes,
yes sir.
Yes. Unless
if you can't do it, there is no meaning.
Right, sir.
Pass will come, pass will come, and the child will come. That's the work.
So for this,
so you can, this is a practical implementation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Five
percent, 5 kg, 1 week,
and it is not computable. You have unfortunately you follow it out the juniors to reach it in India.
Move forward with the next slide. So have we done? Okay, so thank you so much, sir. Have a nice day.